Dear friends, now we will see the vector form of gravitational force. Now we will try to understand the phenomena that how it can be expressed in a vector form. So for that, what we will take? We will take one Cartesian coordinate system. In this Cartesian coordinate system, we consider x-axis, y-axis and z-axis to be arranged in a particular way. So suppose we consider that right now the particle m1 or particle of mass m1 is lying at distance r1 from the origin. Now at the same time, another particle m2 is lying at vector r2 from origin. Now we consider here, suppose the position vector of particle 1 is r1 while the position vector of particle 2 is r2. Now their masses are m1 and m2 respectively. Now suppose we want to find that the force on m2 due to m1. So suppose we want to find that gravitational force on particle m2 due to mass m1. So it can be represented in a vector form, obviously by showing a vector in this manner. Suppose the distance between them is say r. So now how represented r? For that we can use a triangle method of vector addition, and it is very clear that we can apply over that. Here we will get that vector r is equals to r2 minus r1. Now how to get it? It is very simple manner, and we have already studied it in chapter number 3, that method of vector addition. Suppose here in this vector condition we have one vector as r1, so here it is r1. Now another vector is suppose vector r, and the third vector, that is resultant vector, is suppose r2. So what method that we have applied over here is similar to that we know that r2 is represented as r1 plus r. So if we want r as a resultant vector, r will be r2 minus r1. So this is nothing but the vector addition using triangle method. So we have applied nothing else but the method of triangle to solve the example. So this is the simple manner that we have applied and how this equation comes. So that vector r is equals to r2 minus r1 is obtained following this condition. So here that what I have kept, r is equals to r2 minus r1, is the expression that I have explained here. We need not to write in the exam this term because it is accepted. Now I want to find out the gravitational force on particle m2 due to m1. For that, now what I will do, I will apply a simple equation that we know already, that the gravitational force F is directly proportional to the product of the masses, so we know that it is M1 and M2, and it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So now here for the vector form, it is obvious we can also show the direction of the vector. So here we can represent it as vector F is equals to capital G M1 M2 over R square, and with unit vector R with minus sign. Now here interesting to see that how this unit vector will be represented and why the direction is minus. So you can see here that vector R is obtained from this way, that R is R2 minus R1, but obviously here the direction of the force, that direction of the force is from M2 to M1, because the force is acted by particle M1. So the direction of force will be from M2 to M1, and that M2 to M1 is represented by the vector R1 minus R2. So here another interesting thing that we will find, that R vector, unit vector R, is nothing but vector R upon its magnitude. Here again R is already, that is R2 minus R1 upon mod of R. Now R2 minus R1 is kept when its original direction is minus R vector. So we can say that therefore minus R vector means minus of R2 minus R1 over magnitude of R. So now when we replace it over here, we can have the equation, that is vector by particle 1 on particle 2, that is given by F is equals to G, then M1 M2 over R square into, that is with minus sign, we can represent it minus R2 minus R1 over R. Now we represent it with the term minus sign, what will be the resultant? That is minus G M1 M2 over R cube, that is R2 minus R1. So this will be the resultant of the gravitational force that is acted by particle which is acted by particle M1 on M2. Here the opposite of it is also true. We can also write that here, that actually F12 and F21 is represented for that the gravitational force F12 on the body 1 due to 2, and F21 is the force due to 2 on 1. So we can also have that F, this F also can be written as F21, that is minus G M1 M2 over R cube into R2 minus R1. Now its reciprocal is also true, that if we consider whole that phenomena with negative sign, then we can say that F12, that is force due to particle 2 on particle 1. So we will explain it in little detail. So we can say here the above is the force due to 1 on particle 2. Here we will say that force due to M1 on M2 is represented by this way. In a similar way, if we want that force on M1 due to M2 can be represented by F12, that is the same but minus of F21. So that is exactly the opposite phenomena in the direction point of view. So we can say that this follows the third law of Newton's. So that is the vector form of gravitational force between multiple masses. So the gravitational force that acts between more than two masses is also possible to express in a gravitational law with the help of this Newton's law. Here we consider that suppose mass 1 is lying somewhere here. Now another mass 2, that is M2, is lying somewhere here, and it exerts force on 1 that can be represented by F12, that is force on 1 due to M2, and the vector is represented by R12, or it can be represented by minus of R21. So here we have the vector form of the force as well as for the unit vector. Here we consider some another particle, say F force on particle 1 due to some mass 3. So if there is some mass 3, we can say again F13 for the representation point of view, and the unit vector can be represented as R13, or it can be written as minus of R31, that is also the part. Suppose another point mass M4 is there, which also act force on M1. It can be represented by F14 with unit vector, that is R14, or it can be equals to minus of R11. So all things can be considered as the force between multiple particles. Now we want to express in a vector form. Here we should remember that gravitational force is a two body force. So two body force means what? Here we have to remember this term. That is two body force. It is an important term and very crucially important. That two body force means at a time. You can consider the force between four particles That means that we want to find the force on M1 due to M2, M3 and M4, but we cannot write them in a one common equation with the forces that we know that it is directly proportional to the product. So we cannot represent it in the form that this force is like proportional to M1, M2, M3, M4 in this way. because this is not possible in any two body force relation. So we have to remember that this is two body force. This two body force means that at a time, whenever you want to find out the resultant force, you can keep into mind two particles only. That means if the force on particle 1 due to 2, 3 and 4 is to be calculated, we can calculate them separately in the way. Suppose first we calculate it in this way, that is force on particle 1 due to particle 2, then we have to consider that force due to particle 3 on particle 1, then we have to calculate the force on particle m due to particle 4. So each time we have to consider different particles for the different calculation. So then we can add up them algebraically and we can calculate the resultant value, but we cannot put them together at a time. So now we will see that how it can be represented. So here we can say that force on 1 due to 2 is represented as we have already represented it in earlier way, that is G M1 M2 over R12 square. Suppose we want to write in the manner, and then we can represent it with a unit vector, that is R12. So it can be represented in this way. Suppose we want to explain, that is next force on particle 1 due to 3, we can represent it in the form, that is G M1 M3. Here we can have the different type of notation, so here also I will use the textbook form, that is 2 1, here 2 1, and here it will be R31 square with unit vector R31. In a same manner, force on particle 1 due to particle 4 can be represented as F14, that is again G M1 M4 over R41 square into R41 vector. So now we can add up them all to find out the resultant force on particle 1. So ultimately particle 1 experience force, that can be written as a F1, and that is equals to G M1 M2 over R21 square into unit vector R21 plus G M1 M3 upon R31 square and R31 unit vector, plus it can be represented as G M1 M4 over R41 square unit vector R41. So all this is the resultant value, and we have represented the equation, or we can say that this is the representation in a vector form for the multiple forces or the force is due to multiple particle, it can be represented in this manner. So this is the equation that we can obtain for the gravitational force on a particular particle due to more than one particle. So this is called the vector form for multiple particles. Here we have to consider an important term that is called two body force. In this term, that is two body force, we have to keep in mind that at a time we can have the application of one particle on the other particle, not more than that. That means if particle M2, particle M3 and particle M4 acting on particle 1 simultaneously, we cannot calculate the force effect immediate on the one equation, but we can separately calculate the effect of each one on each one. That means particle M2's effect on M1, particles M3's effect on M1 and particles M4's effect on M1, then we have to calculate them separately and add up them into the equation, and we can get the resultant value. So this is called two body force. Dear friends, now we will see an example number 8.2 of our chapter, that is on page number 187. The information is given that three equal masses of m kilogram each are fixed at the vertices of an equilateral triangle ABC. So here the triangle ABC is equilateral triangle, and each vertices of this triangle, that is A, B and C, possesses mass small m. Now we are asked to find out what is the force acting on a mass 2m placed at the centroid capital G of the triangle. So here at the triangle center we have kept capital G, and here there is a 2m mass is situated, and we have to find out the force on it. Here we are also given the information that AG, BG and CG are given as a 1 meter each. So this distance is given as a 1 meter each from here to here. From here to here, this is also 1 meter. This is also 1 meter each from A to G, B to G and C to G. Now what we will do, we will apply the force as per as our equation, that the angle between GC and the positive axis is 30 degree over here, and so on the angle between GB and the relative negative x axis, the individual forces in vector notation can be given as, that is, first we can put FGA. So FGA, that is force acting on G due to A, is given by, that is, G into M into 2M over the distance, that is given as a 1 meter, and obviously that force is acting on Y axis, so it will have, that is, J cap as a resultant force. In the same manner, suppose FGB. So FGB can be represented in a following manner, that is GM 2M over 1. This is common, but here they have the component, that is minus I cap, x component, that will be cos 30 degree, that is cos 30 degree, minus J component, and that will be sin 30 degree. This is obviously due to that is situated on a negative x-axis part. Now the third, that is FGC. So if we go with that term, that is FGC, that is force on G due to C, that is also written as a G into M into 2M. The distance between them, that is 1 meter, but here that will be plus I cos 30 and minus J sin 30 degree. So now we want to find out the resultant value. So for the resultant of the vector, what will be the term? That is FR is equals to FGA, this is FGA, plus FGB plus FGC. So when we calculate the resultant value, we can have the resultant part as we can calculate it with the term, that is 2gm square in j cap plus 2gm square minus I cos 30 degree minus J sin 30 degree plus 2gm. So we can again say that plus 2gm square, here it will be I cos 30 degree minus J sin 30 degree. So it will result obviously into that zero, because everything will cancel each other's effect. In a same manner, we are asked to find out the second part, that they have given that in place of A, if the mass is doubled, then we can say that if mass at A becomes 2m, then what will happen? That in that case, the resultant of this force, that is FR, will be 2 times for the first particles, that is 4 times gm square on j cap, and then it will be minus of 2 gm square on j cap for the remaining 2 particles, and therefore the resultant will be, that is 2 gm square and in a j direction. So this will be the resultant. For the gravitational force between an extended objects like the earth and point mass, this is that applicable equation, and we can apply it in a manner.